Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077. Are you wearing that thing and smoking?
Yes.
Okay. Well, we gotta head take care of three more cyber psychos. Vehicle. Well, it doesn't come in here, I guess. This is not a street that you drive on. I don't know what I think anymore. Get away from my car!
Come out! Hands where I can see him! Take him away!
Who's that? That's an NCPD Netrunner. I thought he was coming after me. Just don't run behind my car and make me run you over. Which way am I going? This way? I decided to start moving again, huh? That was beeping. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Get out of my way. The bodies are hitting the floor. Let them hit the floor like that. One moment? Yeah, I'll give you a moment. She's coming to get me. Yeah. Oh, well. Back to North Side. Must be getting close to that Cyber Psycho. I can already hear the spooky tension in the air, kinda. Oh, I don't turn here, I turn up there. I went through a red light. Ha! Maelstrom goon.
We got a situation.
Got a situation? Something like that. I need this area cleared out before we deal with these cyber psychos. Okay. Synaptic thingy is ready.
Hey, look.
Oh.
Well, well.
Well, this time you disappeared before I looked away. What's that? Your trauma team policy is expired. Immediate action required. That rhymes. Dear client, we regret to inform you that your trauma team policy has expired due to lack of payment. Please remember to activate your card immediately so we may continue to keep you healthy and safe in life's most dangerous moments. You can't afford to hesitate when your livelihood is at stake. Trauma team. Cause of death. Quantity of blood indicates deep wounds. Traces of alcohol present. That one's still alive? Is it a Maelstrom who had his face removed? Oh, his implants that replace his face? You know what I mean. Seems like it. Well, he's gonna be hanging out up there, isn't he? He's gonna run up there, run around. Oh, I see you. Oh, there's just a fanatic over there.
I'll be your friend.
No, you won't. Oh, he's still alive? Gleb? Is that the one? Is he a cyber psycho?
It's just a matter of time, motherfucker!
Because he took that, and he's still alive.
Come out! I'll be your friend!
I think you're gonna be my friend.
Just a matter of time, motherfucker!
Huh. I left that off there. I am sneaking, right? Yeah, okay. A zealot. Gleb. Well, that time we got him. Can't be it. No, because we haven't defeated the Cyber Psycho. 50 meters? That way? So this isn't even it, I don't think. Seems like a good place for it, I don't know. So that's not it. Oh, well, the place is full of Maelstrom goons. I'm assuming these are more... Well, these are scavengers. Yes, run, you fools. I got three there at once? Shouldn't be around here anyway. There's Maelstroms, scavengers, and a cyber psycho somewhere around. Things are going so bleeping well. Pardon me. I killed him right in front of you. Now they're telling me to go back this way. I could have sworn it said to go back that way. Is he just moving around? meters. They keep moving it. Tell me to go this way. Completely disappear this time. So over here then? I need to investigate this crime scene here. What? Wait, wait. Ellis. Oh, crap. Cyber wheel malfunction. Whoa! No! Oh crap. I was trying not to kill him outright. So close. Now is this? Yeah, I still gotta take care of these guys. I'll be right back, guys. I'm gonna kill these guys. Well, I'm gonna collect. I did kill them. I'll collect them the same way, all their stuff. Go over there and kill those, and I'm gonna run over here. And you'll see me then. It says, remember your NDAs. Non-disclosure agreements. And then it said something about losers. Leakers or losers. Put a save in there, because he might kill us again. Fight me! He's moving! Malfunction! Reaching! I don't need that. Look at that, in slow motion. Did he die? Did I kill him? Are you still alive? Sweet. Skill shard for breach protocol. Archive conversation with Brick and Ellis. I'll read it. Ellis says, WTF are we gonna do, Brick? Got a bad feeling Royce wants to screw you in the ass and he's got the people to back him. We gotta do something. Brick says, where the hell have you been? I'm a hundred bleeping percent sure he's gunning for my reins. I've been a walking corpse since yesterday. My advice is to GTFO while you can. Ella says, you're rolling over? We have people too. Jesus, Brick, I'm not going to work for that rusty, and that psycho douche smirk of his. Brick says, don't write that kind of stuff, Al. You believe in me so much. Believe me when I say you gotta get out. Ella says, oh, screw you. Crap your shorts all you want, but I won't let Royce get away with this. Royce from Maelstrom? I remember Royce. So who is this? Ellis Carter. So he's from Maelstrom. Wanted for debt evasion, murder of an NCPD officer, forced cyberware installation, and assault. Hold on, I stopped my timer. With that, okay. Alright, so now we're not done because we need to search for information. This was the guy who said he was had some alcohol in him, right? That's not saying it, showing anything. Archive conversation with Hoof and Sanders. What do these names? Hoof says, today is your day to clean up after Brick's pet or else the boss man finds out we made a rabid dog out of the corpse he wanted. Sanders says, I swear to God, he makes more messes than he cleans up. Hoof says, it's kind of like having our own trained cougar or something. Sanders says, for real, even howls and growls and craps so much I can't sleep. WTF you do that he screams so much. Just showed him what happens when you stand up to Royce. It was Dora's idea to strip out his old chrome, plus we beat his face like it was a skeef-filled piñata. Oh my god. Can't really talk no more, just howls like the traitor he is. But that means you gotta grab the mop and clean up all them fleshy bits and blood he leaves lying around after dealing with our problem customers. Gonna stink it up in here soon and score off all the eddies. Sanders says, then get him inside and away from the trash cans already. Ain't complicated. Oh no, this is poor guy, because he's a traitor, apparently. Cause of death. Body sustained grievous wounds. What's that? Drug inhaler. Empty inhaler with traces of RPM. Drug used for torturing. Blood traces and saliva matches Ellis Duarte. Blood loss from multiple wounds. Evidence of drug use. Same. Same. And same. And then here, got some stuff. They have anything on them? Probably not. Send the information to Regina. Alright. I thought his name was Ellis. Ellis Carter. Didn't the other one say Ellis something other? My bad. It already healed off. Alright, send the information to Regina. Got it. There we go. I don't need to remind you that this is the Maelstrom hotspot. If you confirm a cyber psycho is behind this, please do try to keep them alive. Thanks. I guess you mean the cyber psycho, not the Maelstrom goons. It was a gang dispute. This guy was one of Brick's people. Tried to take revenge on Royce. You can guess how his solo attempt at a vendetta panned out. Got pumped full of drugs, tortured, and maimed into this wild attack dog of a bouncer. As requested, I didn't flatline him, but honestly, I doubt there's much left to collect in the mental sense. So I scrounged up some more info. It looks like the guy was Brick's only devotee left. All his other followers turned coat in half a millisec. I'm not sure he can be saved, but maybe we'll at least learn something new about the onset of cyberpsychosis. Nice work. Thank you. Cool. Alright, so we've got this one now. Bloody Ritual. And then 6 feet under, and then we're done with the cyber psycho stuff. I think there might be some reading to do. I can pad out the episode a little bit. Delamine. Dear Mrs. V, I believe I have discovered the cause of my technical difficulties. Each Delamine vehicle is equipped with a simplified AI core that is responsible for the vehicle's autonomy in critical situations when contact with the core has been ruptured. If my assessment is correct, the AI cores have seceded from the Delamine network and gone rogue, so to speak. I am still attempting to work out how. Alright, so it was last episode or the one before where we actually finished up all the Delamine quests. I forget what they're called. It's a weird name. But yeah, we found all the cars. So, you mean your cars are sentient? I want to say Apotheosis, but no, that's Enderal. It's a weird name like that. Apologies, it seems my explanation was more than a little incoherent. Given the complexity of the situation, allow me to use a metaphor. Imagine a human organ deprived of vital resources, which then causes it to grow larger as a form of overcompensation, such as cardiomegaly. Am I saying that right? Cardiomegaly? I don't know. Unfortunately, however, I am dealing with a sickness, not with evolution. What do you think could have caused this? Indeed, that is the question. At first, I suspected that the software's increasing complexity and desire to become autonomous resulted in the vehicles to become ipso facto autonomous. Nevertheless, I cannot rule out a virus, for what are the chances that all vehicles would become afflicted simultaneously? I am in the process of analyzing a glitch observed just before contact was severed with the vehicles. Perhaps there's where the answer lies? Think of your time. I will be in touch. Good stuff. Let me know if anything else happens. So, let me say we sit in the car and do a little reading. Morgan Blackhand, Street Iron. Not too long. In an age of thousands of target tracing add-ons, a smorgasbord of firearms with Karoshi optics modules and other bells and whistles, let's pause for a second to examine an undying classic constitutional arms liberty model. People sometimes forget that technology isn't perfect, even if your device hasn't betrayed you yet. One day it will. The day will come when you'll have to pick up your gun with your own hand, aim it with your own naked eyes, and pull the trigger. Old school. And followers of the old school always knew that the best choice was the Liberty. Simple enough to hammer a nail, complex enough to mow down a dozen gangoons in seconds. Okay. Alright, so that's this entire thing, yeah. That's articles. And then leaflets. People of Night City, a gem of Japanese elegance. Hanako Arasaka's visit to Night City is a unique chance to take a closer look at a true icon of class and style. The enigmatic daughter of a recently deceased Megacorp CEO has shown us once again why she's a real queen of killer taste. First thing to note is that Hanako wore only Japanese designers, showing off a flair for the patriotism and devotion she was raised with. Take out the her. Second, only a sharp eye might catch the small golden brooch crafted in the shape of the Arasaka Corp logo. Playing it safe but keeping it classy, Hanako also rocked a dove white Neomil pencil dress, simultaneously showcasing a regal modesty but without putting off stiff prudishness. Hanako is corporate royalty and she knows it. She's not trying to squeeze in any of the Neo K flash because her self-confidence is chrome-plated. That said, there are a few accents of gold in her dress, shoes, and hair accessories that tastefully elevate the outfit and harmonize beautifully with her nails and real skin seams. Then, with her coat sporting a fierce red, she adds an almost predatory pop to the ensemble. Color choice by coincidence? No way. Or a nod to the Japanese national colors? Probably way. As we've seen time and again before, Hanako doesn't shy away from incorporating both traditional and modern elements from her home country's heritage. Well, good for her. That's all I have to say about that. Notes. Other. Dr. Havoc and Radon. I just picked this up recently. Introduction. The battery sphere is in dire straits. The Irinians have occupied almost half the city. Them and their Technorat Scourge have transformed almost everyone into hordes of mindless zombies. Battery Arena is now the final point of resistance against the invaders from Planet X. It seems the end is inevitable. That is, until the legendary mercenary pair arrive, just in the nick of time after years of mysterious absence. Amidst the cigar smoke and glint of chrome armor, Dr. Havoc and Radon slaughter scores of enemies without mercy. After all, who could possibly slow the mighty force of a laser-armed mountain of muscle and his spitfire of a sidekick who can transform into a sentient cloud of radioactive gas? Really? That's his power? He transforms into a cloud of radioactive gas. I'll tell you, no one so far. Rose Tenorio and Martoni Elizar take us into the world of computer games, first imagined in the bestseller novel Kibble and Scop by Abe Frost. Fasten your seatbelts and get ready for a roller coaster ride of comic book violence. If you've ever wondered what the action of the Battery Arena may have looked like, Dr. Havoc and Radon is a must-buy. Dive in now. So, is this a computer game, or a novel, or a comic book? I guess it's a comic book that takes place inside a video game, inspired by a novel. Shrug. Other. Yeah, these are all the conversations. That's it. Oh. We're done. Thought we had more stuff to read. Now, the database, I gotta read up on. Right, some of this stuff. Okay. So, we gotta read about the vehicles, but I'm not gonna do that yet, because there's a lot of them. We get caught up on some of this stuff, these weapons. Militech M179 Achilles. Just like Achilles, mythical, nearly invincible warrior of ancient Greece, this Militech weapon is also unsurpassed in its class. The M179 Achilles is truly the best electromagnetic precision rifle on the market. The Achilles features an ultra-long range alongside fierce power, meaning the bullets hit home just as hard, even at great distances. A sniper equipped with the Achilles can easily pierce through walls or armored vehicles. Now, the mythical Achilles had one fatal weakness. What about his namesake? Well, perhaps one flaw would be its complicated, difficult-to-use construction, not to mention its steep price point. That's why the M-179 Achilles is hard to find on Night City's mean streets. Tsunami Ashura. In the good old days, to be sniper meant being an elite sharpshooter, the best of the best, with eagle eyes, nerves of steel, and iron asses. To ensure their one and only shot didn't sail by the target, they had to consider dozens of factors that could affect the bullet's path. Today, anyone who has the right cyberware and a padded bank account can be a deadeye marksman. The Tsunami Sniper Rifle patches target intel and magnified images directly into optical cyberware, and it can automatically compensate for deviations in projectile trajectory. Say that five times fast. Projectile trajectory. The Ashura has the spotter built directly into the hardware. Never miss again. Okay. Alright, so ICE. ICE stands for Intrusion Countermeasures Electronics, the most advanced form of security on the net. Every sane corporation has a crack division of netrunners making sure their data fortress is well protected. Meanwhile, every self-respecting netrunner does everything they can to find a backdoor in corporate ICE and gain access to their subnet. Cutting through very thick ICE requires a lot of skill, precision, and dumb courage. Otherwise, you may end up with your synapses fried to a crisp. Words to the wise. Anything else new? There's something new here. Yeah. The city and surrounding areas. Shinto Shrine. Japantown isn't just restaurants with signs in kanji and nightclubs playing J-laser pop. It's a hub for Japanese culture, a home for those with strong connections to the land of the rising sun, both material and spiritual. Many visit this shrine to learn more about Japanese tradition or to simply take a break from the rat race of the city. Empathy. If you're a mid-ranking corpo and want to get your freak on, then head straight to Empathy in downtown. This brain dance strip club, I don't ever look at anything like that, run by Larry Fanghorn and Adam Ibrahimovic, offers the city's most zero-inducing entertainment? Or O-inducing? But nothing that would gross out your colleagues. The dancers are chipped with the latest chrome, the drinks pack a kick, and the air is saturated with music, lights, and desire. Then again, I really didn't go in that place, because we kept crashing, and then I ended up going upstairs from it, so we didn't actually see it, I don't think, then. Districts? It says new, but there's nothing new. This says new, too, but there's nothing new. Bulwark. Bulwark is a shopping center situated right on the Wellsprings waterfront. There you can find good quality implants as well as bars and eateries to suit any palate. The clean, well-maintained Bulwark is also a great place for a walk, even if you don't plan on grabbing some new chrome. Wakako? Well, there's nothing written about her. What's her little story? Oh, well. Poor Wakako. Alright. So, I'm gonna call in an episode here. We're gonna look for the next Cyber Psycho. The next episode, The Bloody Ritual. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.